Module number two, understanding horses, their individual natures, learned behaviors, and what motivates them. Our topic is self-preservation modes. Which one does your horse choose? Learning objective. Here we explore a horse's self-preservation mode, a fight, flight, and freeze. Wild horses are not reactive, however our domesticated horses are. Wild horses know that if they react to everything that startles them, they would become distracted, thus easier prey for predators. So why are most of our domesticated horses reactive and stuck in one or several self-preservation modes? It's because they have poor role models and unhealthy influences. Our domesticated horses' natural self-preservation has become overridden by learned behaviors, meaning what we understand to be and look like self-preservation is really our horse's way of coping and dealing with perceived danger, stress, and anxiety. This video explores the reasoning behind the learned behavior, perceived as self-preservation, and explains the characteristics common to each mode. So what I'm talking about is we're all taught that fight, flight, and freeze are the core self-preservation modes within equine psychology and nature. And I'm here to tell you that a horse will result to using those preservation modes, but only in extreme cases and very rarely, if you're a wild horse and if you're an untainted horse. Our domesticated horses rely on them all the time. They use them all the time. So again, what we think is normal is not normal. I will now explain the characteristics and actions of each preservation mode, as well as the common temperament and nature of the horse associated with the mode they choose most often. I will also talk about the subtle signs, the warnings that tell you what can happen before it happens, before the horse chooses a self-preservation mode and escalates. Our first mode is fight. Horses are resistant to pressure. They pull, they run through you, they charge, they kick out, they buck, they bite, and they show aggressive behavior. The subtle signs. They're resistant to pressure. They pull. They're resistant to contact. There's no ability to steer. They're hard to move forward, hard to back up. They rear, they buck, they pin their ears when asked. Their temperament. They're more dominant and predominantly a low sensitivity level. So Zor's first mode, as I said, is freeze. So I know for a fact by working with him that he's a more dominant horse by nature. Doesn't mean he's confident. Doesn't mean he's courageous either. But he is more dominant by nature. That's his temperament, his personality. He's also a very high self-esteem type of horse. So self-esteem is different than confidence and it's different than courage, but they're similar. So for him, he has a very low sensitivity level when it comes, his nature has a lower sensitivity level when it comes to how he would normally interact with his surroundings or respond to his surroundings. So while I see the freeze mode and then the flight mode and then he wants to bolt and run away, I know deep down that that's not his true nature. I know that his true nature is a much more easygoing horse. Why? Because the dominance in him tells me so. The dominance in him tells me that he's lazier by nature, that he would prefer to do less than more, and that includes working. But because of the way the experiences that he's had before I got him and the training that he's had, it made him a very unconfident learner. He also has not had a lot of experience with trail riding. He has here, but we don't have a lot of woods. So any, extra sensory, stimulation just really starts to blow his mind if he doesn't feel safe. And what does the flight zone or the flight mode look like? So now we're going to talk about the self-preservation mode of flight. So a horse takes off, they bolt, they drop a shoulder spin, run. They run sideways, they jig. They're often very agitated. Those are some of the signs. Now they get agitated before, they can't stand still. They're very nervous. And of course they're very overstimulated and hypervigilant, too tuned in like Zor can be and too preoccupied and sensitive with their surroundings. So those are some of the characteristics of a horse that is very flighty, or a horse that's becoming and escalating to become very flighty. The subtle signs, it always begins with nervous energy, an inability to stand still, high-headed, tense, tight body, wide eye. Now their temperament, they're usually very passive and predominantly a medium sensitivity level. So most of us think that a horse that goes into flight is a high sensitivity level, when actually they're not. They're medium. Now it can waver. It can go up and down. But they're usually a medium sensitivity level, believe it or not. So here we have a horse that chooses freeze. That's a lower sensitivity level. He actually is a very easygoing horse and lazy. Now we've got the flight mode. It's more of a medium sensitivity level, and a horse that's going to be more reactive, definitely. But their temperament with the flight, they're, when they choose flight, their temperament, you have to think about that. And when I think of temperament, I always use the barometer or the gauge of sensitivity. Horses, many things, and they're going to show up as many things until you get a foundation and they have a strong sense of themselves, well-being, emotional agility, balance, and ease. Until they feel safe, your horse is going to have 4 million different personalities and temperaments, when actually they're just being reactive. Remember, he can freeze, go into flight, and choose fight. He's not going to stay stuck in one. Some horses do. But Zor will actually go into all three, which makes him very challenging and dangerous, because he will bolt, and you can't stop this 2,000-pound draft. So again, I'm really emphasizing the difference between identifying, learning how to read the nature of your horse, and then learn behaviors. Most of what, 98% of what you read right now with Zor is a learned behavior. He's choosing certain self-preservation modes because that's a coping mechanism for him. That is not who he is. He's actually, his dominance, because he's a more dominant horse by nature, that is what starts to tell you who he is and starts to give you the guidelines to read your horse and understand who they are. So the last self-preservation mode is freeze. And I've been talking a lot about Zor being the frozen type and then going into flight or fight. So now we're going to talk about freeze mode. So that's pretty easy. When a horse is in a freeze mode, they literally freeze. They stop moving their feet. They check out. They go on autopilot. They're non-responsive to your aids and the environment. They're kind of dead, like trail riding. They're dull to your aids, they're not responsive, and they appear calm, but they're actually overwhelmed, and they choose to check out to cope. Subtle signs. So they may have a low headset, like this right now, while you're riding them, or working with them. But let's talk about riding. So he might have a lower headset, but how does his body feel underneath of you? And if you use a subtle aid, whether it's to go faster, to slow down, to steer, move the shoulder to the right or the left, does your horse respond to that subtleness? So often our frozen horses are so checked out and on autopilot, they are very non-responsive, bottom line. And if you pay more attention to figuring out if they're in the freeze mode, you know, how do they feel when you ride? Are they tight? Bracing against you, you know, you can't steer them, you can't move them, can't get them to go forward. It's hard. So let's talk about the horse's temperament. A horse that freezes is more submissive, predominantly high sensitivity level. So here we have Zor that's very dominant by nature. He chooses the freeze mode. This is what makes it so complex, because it's a learned behavior. So he chooses the freeze mode to cope. That's his first self-preservation mode. Then he goes into flight and then fight. And the fight shows up by pulling and pushing through your aids, you know, when we're on the ground, he'll pull me and run sideways, or he'll toss his head all cocky and have a tantrum and rear up a little bit. So that's your fight. The flight's usually a straight bolt, but he chooses freeze. And that's when he just gets, it gets harder and harder for him to move, harder and harder for him to be responsive. He was like that all the time the first 6 months I got him. And then I slowly got him out of that, and then he started to wake up, and then he became this really flighty horse that we have today. So now we have to deal with that. We get into the temperaments. You know, a horse that fights is more dominant, and he's got that in him, just by nature, period. That's your fight. It's a little more aggressive. Higher self-esteem, higher self-preservation, take care of themselves. A horse that goes into flight, and usually, again, the horse that goes into fight has a low sensitivity level. They're not affected by too much. They'd rather just put up a fight. A horse that goes into flight has a medium sensitivity level, not a high, a medium. And remember, I'm gauging, my barometer for sensitivity is how tuned in they are to their environment, how responsive and reactive they are. And those horses are more submissive. And then you have your freeze, more passive horse by nature. He's a very easygoing horse until he gets pushed into a self-preservation mode. So see how tricky this can be. And you're not gonna know how to read what is what until you work with your horse consistently enough and start to see patterns. You know, you start doing this specific exercise here, and then you take it there, and then you're taking it somewhere else. And does your horse show up the same way? Do they react the same way? Who are they? Try this. As you read this, you probably have a specific situation in mind that you've experienced with your horse. Go to your horse and take him or her toward that situation again, and be present, very aware and observant to what happens. How does your horse show up? How do they respond or react to that situation? Pay attention to the subtle nonverbal signs of your horse when they're communicating. So this is what I refer to as reading the thought before they commit to the action. If we become masters of observation, reading the thought, we can stay safe. This is because we have caught the thought before they commit to the action, before our horse does something really dangerous or unpredictable. Here's a problem-solving strategy and tip. Take it real slow. Look into your horse's eyes with loving attention so you can observe the fight, flight, or freeze that is coming on. As soon as you see the subtle signs in your horse, stop and retreat. Back off right away. Go back. If you retreated on time before they escalate, you should see the relief in your horse's eyes and the ease in their body again. And maybe a lick and a chew. And this tells you they feel safe. So these are thresholds that I want you to work with your horse. So again, if you're paying attention and you're moving your horse up to this scary situation or a new area that you're working in or riding, and you see the tension and you feel the apprehension and you see the apprehension, stop. That's a threshold. Pay attention to it. Or stop before it gets even bigger. Turn away. That's called retreat. Maybe 10 feet, 20 feet, 30 feet. Face the direction that you're in and stand. So now you're being very respectful of a threshold. Let your horse process this threshold. Let them get comfortable. Let them relax. And then you'll move forward again, and you'll keep playing with those thresholds, with the threshold of where they feel safe and the threshold where they start to get triggered. You're going to keep playing with those thresholds. So you're not going to go back and retreat and then push them back up to that threshold. I want you to keep playing with it and paying attention to it. And the key thing is that your horse keeps trying, that they don't get stuck. And if they get stuck, then there's all sorts of ground exercises that I would want you to do. I wouldn't want you to be kicking them if you're riding. That can get very dangerous. I'd rather you get down and work on sending them into those thresholds, back and forth, until they can eventually, whether you're on them or on the ground, can stand in that new threshold and find safety. They've got to feel safe. And then comfort. Until your horse feels safe, you can't teach them anything. You won't change anything, because they are in self-preservation mode. Write it down. Please write down your observations and experience with your horse during this process. Writing it down helps you to better process and analyze a situation, thus develop excellent problem-solving skills. And of course, you can always videotape, my number one favorite thing to do. I look forward to hearing from you in the comments area. May you always be one with your horse. Thank you.